So this is the state of the processor. We have some instructions fetched. This is the very first one that we will be trying to issue. This is our reservation stations, our register file with the values, the RAT that says where the values are currently, and it's pointing to the register file for now, the ROB that is empty for now. This is a little table that we will be writing what happens in which cycle. And then this is kind of the legend for our reservation stations and ROBs, because we need to know which field to put which value in. So in cycle one, what's going to happen is we're going to try to issue this first instruction. To do that, we need an available reservation station and an available ROB entry. We have both, so we are ready to go. It's a divide, and we're going to write the divide's kind of operation here. It's writing to R2, so we're going to note that in the destination register over here. We're going to write the destination tag in the reservation station. That's going to be ROB1 now. Remember that the value we broadcast the result with, basically the tag that everybody's trying to compare, is now going to be the ROB entry number, not the reservation station number. That's what allows us to free reservation stations very quickly. The R3 and R4 are going to be looked up here. We will find that it's 45 and 5 and write it here. And then we are going to rename R2 so that it points to ROB1 from now on. And then, because we said that we will be able to dispatch in the very same cycle and begin execution in the next cycle, we have issued this instruction in cycle 1. It's going to begin executing in cycle 2 because both of its operands have values ready to go. Now, in cycle 2, this instruction begins executing, so the reservation station becomes free. Before I free the reservation station, I'm going to note that this instruction is dividing 45 and 5. So the result that is going to eventually end up in the ROB is going to be 9, 45 over 5. This instruction is not done, so technically this value lands here only when it's done, but I'm going to note this is what's going to happen because I want to know what that value will be. And with that, this reservation station becomes free. So now what's going to happen, this is a divide. It's going to take 40 cycles to do things. So in cycle 42, which is the 41st cycle since we began executing, we try to write its result. That's going to be a long time in the future. Meanwhile, in cycle 2, we're going to try to do the rest of the things. Can we dispatch something else? Well, nothing to dispatch. Can we issue something? Well, the multiplication has a reservation station and ROB entry ready to be obtained, so we can do that. It's a mul of R1. The tag for it is now going to be ROB2. R5 and R6, R3 and 4. So we have the values, we don't have to wait for anything. And R1 is our result. Now we need to remember that R1 from now on is mapped to ROB2. Basically, if anybody from now on wants to use R1, it really needs to wait for the result of instruction in ROB2. So this instruction has issued in cycle 2. It's going to dispatch also in cycle 2 because it's ready to go. So in cycle 3, it's going to begin executing. And with that, we have moved to cycle 3.